many tourists. You're watching me dance salsa nightclub style. People call me the Mambo King, the Salsa King, the King of Latin dance. I've been dancing salsa in nightclubs all my life, and I've been teaching over 20 years. Have you ever gone into a nightclub and seen people dancing on the floor and wish you can dance that way? Or have you gone on the floor and looked around and say, somehow I don't fit here, it looks different from what everybody else is doing? Well, over the next 2 hours, I'm gonna teach you how to dance salsa nightclub style the right way. As you watch us dance, let me describe to you some of the elements which make this dance so unique. Let's start with the music. These Latin rhythms are filled with passion, fire, and soul. As you listen to this music, you can't help but get emotionally involved. It literally taps into your innermost feelings, which allows you to express yourself spontaneously and really get down. Let's talk about style. Style is about looking good. It's about the way you move your hands, the way you execute your footwork, the way you look at each other, the way you relax and make everything look so beautiful. But it has to be spontaneous. You do as you feel, spontaneously. If you want to yell, you yell. If you want to drop down on one knee, it's all about being free and being spontaneous. One thing I can say is once you learn my technique, you'll be able to go out with confidence to any nightclub and get down and dance. Thank you very much, Mr. Eddie Montalvo.
You're welcome, Eddie.
What you just saw there was a quick demonstration of what's known as the basic time step. And before we get into our teaching segment, it's very important that we just make mention of how important it is for the dancer to learn how to dance correctly on time with the music. For that reason, I developed the Eddie Torres ear training technique, which is available on audio. We're not going to spend too much time because we do want to get right into the teaching. But quickly, I just want to show you, this is part of the Eddie Torres ear training technique, which is explaining basic music theory as pertaining to your basic time step and your dance in general. What we have here is known as the staff in music, and music is written in measures. We have one measure, which is from here to the center, and from here to here, another measure. The basic time step is executed over two measures of music. This 4-4 simply means that there are four beats per measure. It takes 8 beats to execute one basic step. And the word tempo, which means speed, it's very important to the dancer that he dances correctly on the right tempo. If the music is fast, the dancer must move fast. If the music is medium, he must move accordingly to the pace and the tempo of the music. What I like to do quickly is to demonstrate a basic time step with the assistance of my conguero, and we're going to get right into our teaching, and we'll be explaining more about this music theory as we get into our teaching.
Música, maestro, please.
Now, what he's playing there is a medium tempo, okay? We're going to pick it up and count 8 beats like this. We're going to count, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Notice there's an accent on the 2 and the 6 as we count from 1 to 8. It goes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now, notice how the men break back on the second beat with the right foot and they break forward on the left. But it's important that you dance precisely with the correct tempo, like this. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Notice the right foot breaking on 2, back, and the left foot breaking forward on 6. This is known as dancing on 2. Now, without any further ado, we're going to get right into our teaching segment and explain more as we get into the development of our lesson today. Now, if the music speeds up, you speed up. Maestro? Now, don't go away. We're coming right back to get into our salsa nightclub style. Yeah. Well, now that we have a basic understanding of timing and music and how to follow the tempo, we're going to have DeLille and Duplessis demonstrate for you the most important step of all. This is the foundation step known as the basic time step upon which all other steps are based on. We are now going to begin with the breakdown of the basic time step on ladies' timing. To begin the basic time step, ladies, you start forward with your right foot, a very short step forward on 1, and 1. Be sure your entire body weight is on every step that you take. On the second beat, the left foot moves out in front a little longer on 2, and 2. Your weight is on your left foot. The third beat is what we call in dance stepping in place. You pick the right foot up and you place it right down in the same spot, and 3. Your weight is on the right foot. On the fourth count, you do not step on 4, but you override the 4. As the left foot is up in the air, it's going to travel back, and you're going to go over the fourth beat, stepping with a short step back on 5, and 5. Your weight is on your left foot on 5, then the right foot steps back a little longer on 6, and 6. On 7, like the 3, it's in place. You're going to pick your left foot up and place it right back down in the same spot on 7, and 7. Your weight is on your left foot on 7. And as you start forward again with the right foot, you're going to override the 8th beat and begin again from the very top. Up and 1. Left foot forward. 2. Right foot in place. 3. Over the 4 as you go back. And 5. Right foot back. 6. Left foot in place. 7. Repeat. And 1, 2, 3 over the 4. And 5, 6, 7 over the 8. 1, 2, 3, and 5, 6, 7. And 1, 2, 3 over the 4, 5, 6, 7 over 8. 1, 2, 3 up 4, 5, 6, 7 up 8. And 1, 2, 3 up 4, and 5, 6, a little faster now. 1, 2, 3, and 5, 6, 7. And 1, 2, 3, we're counting the beats that we do step on. You step on 1, 2, 3, you step on 5, 6, 7, and 1, 2, 3, and 5, 6. The pattern consists of a short step, long step in place. Short step, long step in place. Going forward, short, long in place. Going back, short, long in place. And short, long in place, and short, a little more. And 1, 2, 3, and 5, 6, 7. And 1, 2, 3, and 5, 6. Two more times. And 1, 2, 3, and 5, 6, 7, and 1, 2. Continue dancing, Duplessis. Now remember, this is the most important step of all the steps to be learned. So you want to make sure you spend plenty of time practicing and mastering this basic time step. We are now going to break down the basic time step on the men's timing. For the men, the first beat, you will start back taking a short step with the left foot back on one. Be sure your weight is entirely on that left foot. On the second beat, the right foot moves back a little longer and you step on two and two. Your weight is now on your right foot. On three, we're going to step in place by picking up the left foot in the same spot and putting it right back down on the same spot. That's three. That's called stepping in place. Again, as we mentioned, the fourth beat you do not step on. It's an override, which means the foot is up in the air. We call these up beats. So the fourth beat is up in the air. As you're traveling forward, you override the four and you take a short step forward with the right foot on five. Your weight is on your right foot, and then the sixth count is the left foot forward a little longer out in front on six. Your weight is on your left foot on six. And seven, again, is a step where you just step in place, you pick it up and put it right back down on seven. Your weight is on your right foot on seven. As you pick up the left foot and you start traveling back, there is the eight count where you don't step on, but you override. The eight is up in the air. As you start traveling back, you take a short step with the left foot on one, and then the right foot goes back a little longer on two, and the left foot steps in place on three. We're going to repeat this over and over slowly. Over the four, forward with the right foot, five, left foot, six, in place, seven. Over the eight, back one, right foot back, two, in place, three. Over the four as you go forward, five, six, seven, and one, two, three, over the four, and five, six, seven. The pattern consists of a short step, a long step, in place step. A short step, a long step, in place, back, short, then long, and in place. Forward, short step, long step, in place. Repeat, one, two, three, up four, five, six, seven, up eight. And one, two, three, up four, and five, six, seven. A little faster. And one, two, three, up four, five, six, seven, up eight. And one, two, three, up four, and five, six, seven, eight. And one, two, three, four, and five, six, seven, eight. And one, two, three, four, and five, six. Two more times. One, two, three, up four, five, six, seven, up eight. And one, two, three, up four, and five, six, seven. Here we have DeLille and Duplessis demonstrating the basic time step without the contrary body movement. Notice the structure of the step is there, but the body is not moving. Your hips are not moving side to side. Now we're going to show you the contrast difference when you do incorporate the contrary body movement, how it does bring the basic step and the dance to life. Here we go. Ah! It adds all the flavor, all the pizzazz. It brings the step really to life. It's the rhythm of the body. A basic step is not a basic step without contrary body motion. Notice also the styling of the hands, especially for the ladies. Those hands should flow very freely, should be loose at the wrists. The hands and the fingers should be in open position, letting them really flow naturally. The arm movements are correlating with the contrary body motion, which is built on three beats as well as the basic step. For the men as well, hands should be up at the chest level, elbows slightly bent. The arms and the shoulders moving rhythmically within three beats. And of course, the more expressive your contrary body motion is, the more beautiful it is to look at. have Argelio and Maddie demonstrating for you our first open step, which I call the Suzy Q. We're now going to break down Suzy Q. Okay, taking it on the ladies count, we're going to start with the basic step very slowly with the right foot forward. Let's go with the right foot on one, left foot forward on two, right foot in place, three, going back over the four, stepping with the left foot on five, right foot back on six, left foot in place on seven. Now to begin the pattern, you take your right foot and cross over your left on one. Be sure that your weight is on that right foot. The left foot steps in place on two, and then the right foot steps in place on three. The left foot goes over the four, and you cross over, stepping with the left foot on five. The right foot steps in place on six, and the left foot steps in place on seven. You will repeat this again, right foot crossing over on one, left foot steps in place on two, right foot steps in place on three. Over the four as the left foot crosses over, on five, right foot steps in place on six, left foot steps in place on seven. A little faster now, and one, two, three, over the four, and five, six, seven, over the eight, and one, two, three, and five, six. Now forward to your basic step, and one, two, three, and five, six, seven. We will now break down the Suzy Q step on the men's timing. Starting with a half a basic, going back with the left foot on one, right foot back on two, and left foot steps in place on three. To begin, the right foot crosses over the left on five, left foot steps in place on six, right foot steps in place on seven. You override the eight as you cross over with the left on one, then the right foot will step in place on two, left foot steps in place on three. We're going to repeat this again. Right foot crosses over on five, left foot steps in place on six, and then right foot steps in place on seven. Override the eight, and left foot crosses over on one, right foot in place on two, left foot in place on three. We're going to go a little faster. And five, six, seven, over the eight, and one, two, three, over the four, five, six, seven, over the eight, and one, two, three. Back to your time step, forward on five, six, seven, back, one, two, and three. Okay, we will now cover a few pointers in the area of styling, okay? Notice now, while they're doing the Suzy Q, let's focus in on the ladies. Notice that there's a lot of twisting going on at the waist. The knees are slightly bent. She's twisting in three beats as the structure of the step goes. Notice the hands are flowing freely. She's very relaxed. And you're just letting yourself really flow and feel the music. Same thing for the fellas. Notice how he's basically just twisting also. This is the 90s. The fellas can twist at the waist. That's right. His shoulders are very fluid, very relaxed. Also, this is what street dancing is about. You feel the music and you just react spontaneously to it. Notice how they both seem like they're really enjoying this. A little twist here, a little arm movement there. Oh yeah, looking beautiful, dancers. We will now demonstrate the second step known as the Cuban step. Once again, Argelio and Maddie will demonstrate. And Argelio is from Cuba, so he's going to give us a good, genuine interpretation of the Cuban step. We will now break down the Cuban step on the ladies' timing, starting with a half a basic step, right foot forward on one, left foot forward on two, right foot in place on three. We will now begin by taking the left foot, dropping it back on an angle on five. Make sure your weight is on that left foot. Right foot steps in place on six and feet come together on seven. And the right foot drops back on an angle on one. Left foot steps in place on two, feet come together on three. We'll repeat this again. Left foot back on five, right foot in place on six, feet come together on seven. Then the right foot back on one, left foot steps in place on two, feet come together on three. We're going to do it now a little more fluidly. Left foot and five, six, seven, and one, two, three. And five, six, seven, and one, two, three. And five, six, seven, and one, two, three. Dropping the left foot in an angle and the right foot in an angle. Shoulders drop back in an angle, back in an angle. And five, six, seven, and one, two, three. One more time. Five, six, seven, and one, two, three. Now back to your basic step. One, two, three, and five, six, seven, and one. Very nice. We'll now break down the Cuban step on the men's timing. We're going to begin with a full basic time step, starting back with the left foot on one, two, three, and five, six. To begin the step, you drop the left foot back on an angle on one. Be sure your weight is on that left foot. Right foot steps in place on two, and the feet come together on three. Dropping back with the right foot on an angle on five. Be sure your weight is on the right foot. Step in place with the left foot on six, and your feet come together on seven. Repeat again. Left foot back on one. Right foot steps in place. Two. Three together. Right foot drops back. Five. Left foot in place. Six. Feet come together on seven. A little more fluid now. And one, two, three, and five, six, seven. And one, two, three, and five. Let yourself flow and relax. One, two, three, and five, six, seven, and one, two, three, and five, six. Two more times. And one, two, three, and five, six, seven, and one, two, three, and five, six. Now get ready to go back to the time step. Forward with the right foot back to five, six, seven, and one, two, three, and five, six, seven, and one. Very good. Okay, we're going to now focus in on a few pointers for styling in the Cuban step. Now notice how the footwork along with the shoulders is done in an angle. The foot drops back and you drop the shoulders back. Notice the pulsating down and up feeling in the Cuban step. Also notice the arm work. The hands for the lady should always be fluid, hands in open position, always working those hands very gracefully, very beautiful. Notice Argelio, how he has that pulsating arm work. And of course, this street dancing is all about being spontaneous, letting what you feel just happen, okay? Just react to how you feel the music, okay? And enjoy, relax. Be sure that you learn how to have a good time while you're dancing this dance. Very nice. We will now have DeLille and Janice demonstrate for you a single right turn, starting with the basic step. Take it away, DeLille and Janice. And. Aha. A gozar. Oh, yeah. One more time. Thank you, DeLille and Janice. We will now break down the single right turn on ladies' timing. We will begin first by doing a basic time step, starting with the right foot forward, and one, two, three, and five, six, seven. To start the turn, the right foot takes a small step forward on one, the left foot takes a longer step out in front on two, and I want you to notice that the left heel is off the floor. The left knee is slightly bent. You're going to push off the left foot onto the right foot on the count of 3-4, landing with the left foot on 5. The right foot goes back on 6, and the left foot steps in place on 7. We'll repeat this again. Right foot forward on 1, left foot forward on 2. Spin for the count of 3-4, landing on 5 with the left. Right foot goes back on 6, left foot in place 7. We'll try it a little faster now. And 1, 2, spin 3, 4 back, 5, 6, and repeat this. And 1, 2, spin 3, 4, 5, 6 again. And 1, 2, 3, and 5, 6. 2 more times. And 1, 2, 3, and 5, 6, 7. 1 more time. 1, 2, 3, and 5, 6. Back to your time step. And 1, 2, 3, and 5, 6, 7. We will now break down the single right turn on men's timing. We're going to begin first with a single basic time step, starting with the left foot back on 1, and 1, 2, 3, and 5, 6. Again back, 1, 2, stop on 3. To prepare for the single right turn, the right foot goes forward with a short step on 5. Your weight is on that right foot. You now take your left foot forward a little longer step on 6. Now be sure that the left heel is off the floor, the left knee is slightly bent. You're going to pivot and turn, transferring the weight from the left foot onto the right for the count of 7, 8, landing with the left foot flat on 1. Right foot drops back on 2, and left foot steps in place on 3. Begin again, right foot forward short on 5, left foot forward on 6, pivot and turn, 7, 8, landing on 1. Right foot back, 2, left foot in place, 3. A little faster, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, and repeat. And 5, 6, spin 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, and 5, 6, spin 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, again, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 2 more times, and 5, 6, 7, back, 1, 2, 3, once again, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, back to the time step forward, and 5, 6, 7, and 1, 2, 3, and 5, 6, 7, Okay, we are now going to demonstrate a few pointers in styling on the single right turn. Off the basic step, notice that there's contrabody movement in the basic step. Okay, now, as they do the single right turn, I want you to notice that the arms come close to the body as they turn. Ready? Here we go. And as you turn, you want to keep those knees slightly bent, and you want to also tighten up the abdominals, okay? You want to keep the head up, okay? You want to tone down the arms as you turn so it doesn't interfere with your balance. And keep your eyes up at eye level. A few more times. Oh, yeah. Okay, we have now Angel and Duplessis demonstrating the basic time step in closed position. This will now begin our partner work segment, and we will begin by just practicing the basic time step together in closed position. We're going to commence with the basic time step in closed position. Before we do this, I would like to explain to you the proper lead position of the hands for the men and the ladies. To begin, the man takes his left hand and he places it into the lady's right hand. Palm to palm, they create resistance against each other's palm. Next, the man's right hand will be placed in the center of her back, in the middle lower part of her back, pressing her against him, and the ladies, you will create counter resistance by pulling away from him. Ladies' left hand will be placed behind the men's right shoulder. One is at the palms where they press against each other, and the second is where his right hand presses against the center of her back as she pulls away, creating resistance. We're going to begin by breaking down the basic time step in closed position. On the first beat, the men will start back with a short step on 1. Ladies will start forward with the right foot on 1. And 1. Be sure you place your entire body weight on every step that you take. On the second beat, the men will break back a little longer with the right foot on 2. And the ladies will break forward with their left foot a little longer on 2. and two. On the third beat, both dancers will step in place. The men will step in place with the left foot, and ladies will step in place with the right foot. And three. Okay? As we transfer the movement now, the fourth beat we do not step on, we override, which is up in the air. And as the ladies start back on the count of five, she takes a short step back with the left foot on five, and the men go forward with a short step with the right foot on five. And five. On the sixth count, ladies drop the right foot back a little longer with the right foot on six, and the men take a longer step with the left foot forward on six. And six. On the count of seven, the dancers will once again step in place. Ladies will step in place with the left foot on seven, and the men will step with the right foot in place on seven. And seven. Okay? We're going to repeat this just a little faster, starting with the count of one. And one, and two, and three, transfer positions, and five, and six, and seven. We will now do it a little faster, and we will start getting a feeling for this and a flow. You also practice with your partner in this position. Here we go. And one, two, three, and five, six, seven. And one, two, three, and five, six, seven. The pattern is one, two, three, and five. Notice that the footsteps are a short step, long step in place, and short step, long step in place, and short step, long step in place, and short, long in place on the count of one, two, three, and five, six, seven. Remember to override the four and the eight. And five, six, seven, up eight, and one, two, three, up four, and five, six, seven, and one, two, three, and five, six, a little faster, and one, two, three, and five, six, seven, and one, two, three, and five, six, seven, and one, two more times, and five, six, seven, and one, two, three, and five, six, seven, and one, two, three, and five, six, seven. Thank you, dancers. We're now going to focus in on a few fine points in the area of styling. Okay, one of the things you want to notice is the way their hips are swaying from side to side. Notice the coordination. Both hips, his and hers, are moving in the same direction at the same time. Notice the footwork where the pattern is very consistent. It's a short, long in place, short, long in place, short, long in place. That is very, very precise. The basic time step has to be very precise so that you don't step on each other's feet. Also, notice the left hand for the fellas and ladies' right hand is very steady, basically carrying the arm position at shoulder level. Remember the two points of resistance, palm to palm, and the right hand pressing against her back. Also notice how romantic it looks when they look at each other, eye to eye. Yes. Relating with each other. Just having a good time. Styling begins at the feet, works its way right up to the head. It's a question of looking good from head to toe. And above all, you relax and enjoy yourself. Oh, can't you just wait to go out to the nightclubs and dance? Okay, now we have Angel and Duplessis demonstrating the crossbody lead. It's the first move you do, which will initiate all of the turn patterns. Take it away, Angel and Duplessis. Repeat. Notice how he leads her out and sets her up in ready position for the turns, which are to follow. Oh, beautiful. Once again. We'll now do the breakdown for the crossbody lead, we'll begin with a basic time step. Men will begin back with the left foot on one, and ladies will begin forward with the right foot on one. Basic time step, and 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, stop on 7. All right, in ready position, the first beat, the men will have their weight on their right foot. As they pivot off that right foot, they're going to do a quarter left turn, placing the left foot parallel to the right foot on one. When the men does this, the ladies lead forward with a short step with the right foot on one. Ready? And one. Notice his left foot is parallel to the right, and her right foot is forward. Ladies, your weight will be on your right foot. This position clears her path to be able to continue moving forward across his body and avoiding stepping on his feet. Okay, on the second beat, the men will mark the second beat with the right foot in place, up and down, as the ladies take a longer step with the left foot on two. Ready? And two. Okay, at this point on the third beat, the ladies have their weight placed on the left foot as the men lead her out with the right hand and release her at the back. She also releases her left hand off his shoulders. She will be executing a half of the left turn, landing with the right foot on three. The fellows will then pivot and turn a quarter left turn, placing the left foot into a quarter turn position and the right foot into a quarter left turn position. Ready? And three. At this point, they've released each other, and they're now going to execute a basic time step before we would begin any of the turn patterns. Time step is, and 5, 6, 7, and 1, 2. He will recover her and repeat this again. 5, 6, stop on 7. Okay, from this angle, again, on one, the men will begin by executing a quarter left turn, placing the left foot parallel to the right foot, and ladies, you take a short step with the right foot forward on one. Ready? And one. Okay, on the second beat again, men's right foot marks the second beat up and down in place while the lady steps forward with a longer step on two. And two. Okay, on the third beat again, she will be placing her weight on the left foot as he leads her out and releases her by giving her a firm push at her back. She will then turn a quarter left turn with the weight on the left foot, and then as she creates that quarter left turn, her right foot will land flat on the beat of three. For the men on three, he pivots off the right foot and turns the left foot a quarter left turn, stopping there on three. Ready? And three. Notice how he has released her, and he will now continue forward to the forward half of his basic as she starts back with her left foot to the back half of her basic. And 5, 6, 7, and 1, 2. Recover her and repeat a little more fluidly. Here we go. And lead her out. 1, 2. Release. 3. Basic step. 5, 6, 7. And 1, 2. Recover. 5, 6. And repeat. And 1, 2, 3. Release. 5, 6, 7. Basic. 1, 2, 3. One more time. 5, 6, 7. Lead her out. 1, 2. Release on 3. 5, 6, 7. And 1, 2, 3. And 5, 6, 7. One more time. 1, 2, 3. And 5, 6, 7. And 1, 2, 3. And 5, 6, 7. Back to the basic. 1, 2, 3. And 5, 6, 7. And 1, 2, 3. And 5. Thank you, Angel and Duplessis. Very, very nice. Remember, the crossbody lead is the move that you use to initiate all of the turn combinations. Let's talk a little bit about style in the crossbody lead. Style is simply looking good from head to toe. Everything you do, starting with your footwork all the way up, has to do with your style. For example, let's start off with Angel. Notice even his smile adds to his style. His head is up. Notice how he's carrying a rhythmical upper body movement. That also looks very stylish. Also very important on this crossbody lead, when the men, you lead her out, be sure that you carry a firm but sort of gentle lead. Okay, not too hard, but it has to be firm. For the ladies, look at how rhythmical Duplessis is moving her body. Let's look at her left hand when he releases her. Notice how the arm and all the way down to her hand, there's a sense of rhythm. Notice how relaxed her hand and her fingers are. That also adds to your style, ladies. It's very important for you ladies to work on developing very beautiful dancing hands, as I call it, to add beautiful style to your dance. Remember, when you go out to the nightclubs and dance salsa, always do it with style. Thank you, Angel and Duplessis. Now we have Angel and Duplessis demonstrating for you next a cross-body lead into a left-hand single right turn. We are now ready to begin with the breakdown of the cross-body lead into a single right turn. Before we do that, I'd like to make a few pointers on the technique of the handwork for leading the turns. Before you begin to initiate the turns, the men must first, and the ladies, release your thumbs. After the thumbs are released, the ladies must change their hand from a palm to palm to a palm up position before he executes the cross-body lead with her. The man's hands must stay relaxed as she's changing the position from palm to palm to palm up. The next pointer is he must raise his hand a few inches above her head and a few inches close to her head before executing the single right turn. We will first start out with a basic time step, do a full basic. We will stop and they will pick it up from there and break it down step by step and beat by beat. We'll begin with the basics time step, starting on the first count. Ladies, right foot forward, and men, left foot back. And one, two, three, and five, six, and stop. Okay, to begin the single right turn, the ladies will step with a short step forward with the right foot on one. Your weight will be on that right foot. At the same time, the fellows will bring his left foot back, a short step on one. His left foot will be parallel to his right. And one. At this point, the second beat will be the lady's left foot forward, a little longer on two, and remembering that the left foot is placed on the ball, the knee is slightly bent, and the heel is off the floor. The men on two will break back with their right foot on two, taking a little longer step back on two, and placing the right foot on the ball. And two. You are now in preparation for the turn. At this point, the left hand has gone up a few inches above her head, and men will now command the lead. You'll use the count of 3-4 to turn. After the turn, ladies will be breaking back on 5-6-7, which is the back half of her basic step, and the men will be breaking forward on 5-6-7, which is the frontal half of his basic step. And 3-4-5-6-7, and 1-2, recover her, and lead her out and repeat. And 1-2, release, 5-6-7, 1-2, turn, 5-6, again. He leads her out, 1-2-3, and 5, prepare for the turn, and 1-2, spin 3-4, back to basic, 6-7, and 1-2-3, and 5-6-7, command the lead, 1-2, recover, 5-6, again, 1-2-3, and 5-6-7, and 1-2, one more time, 5-6-7, cross body lead, single right turn, and 1-2, recover, and 5, basic step, and 1-2-3, and 5-6-7. Let's talk about the style in the cross body lead into the single right turn. First thing I'd like to point out is the arm work that Angel's doing. Notice how the left arm comes up and rhythmically leads her in a circular motion around over her head. Next, let's focus in on Duplessis' left hand. Notice how she keeps it close to her body while she's spinning. And then rhythmically, she comes back out and places it on his shoulder. Very smooth, very stylish. The last point I'd like to make is how Angel recovers her after the spin. Notice the stylish attitude he uses as he goes to recover her with that right arm, with a very, very debonair attitude. Thank you, dancers. Very nice. Demonstrating our first turn pattern at beginner level. This is called alternating right turns, demonstrated by Angel and Duplessis. Now break down the first turn pattern at level one, known as the alternating right turns. We'll begin by first breaking down the arm work, and afterwards we will work on the footwork and the timing with the crossbody lead. We will start out in starting position, which will be the men's left hand palm down, holding his partner's right hand palm up. With the left hand, we're going to lead her first into a single right turn. Remember, you must release your thumbs before you lead her into any of the turns. So we'll begin by turning her to the right clockwise. Now the men will drop the left hand down to their waist level, and as they lead them, you lead yourself through a clockwise right turn, you're going to switch from left hand to right hand behind your back. After the switch, you continue turning to the right. Once you face your partner, you lead her with the right hand into another single right turn. Now you switch from right hand back to left hand, and you will assume the lead position, right hand, the man's right hand around her waist and her left hand on top of his right shoulder. We will repeat this once again. Starting position, man's left hand holding her right. With the left hand, he will lead her first into a single right turn, releasing the thumbs before he turns her. After the turn, the men will bring the left hand down to your waist level. You will turn to the right, switching from left to right hand behind the back. Continue turning once you face her. With the right hand, you lead her into another single right turn, switching the hand back into your left hand and recovering her back to lead position. Okay, we will now begin the breakdown with the basic step crossbody lead into the alternating right turns. Beginning with a basic time step, the men will start with the left foot back on one, ladies with the right foot forward on one. We will execute a basic step, then a crossbody lead, and we will pick it up from there and break down the alternating single right turns. And one, two, three, five, crossbody lead, and one, two, three, and five, six, seven. You will turn her on one, two, three, the men will turn on five, six, seven. Once again, you turn on one, two, three, you recover her, five, six, basic step, and one, two, three, and five, six, repeat. Cross body lead, five, six, seven. She turns on one, two, three, fellas turn five, six, seven. She turns one, two, you recover her, back on five, six, seven. Once again, one, two, three, five, six, cross body lead, one, two, three. Remember to release the thumbs. You lead her one, two, three, you turn, five, six, seven. You turn her one, two, three, you recover her, five, six, basic step, and one, two, three, and five, six, seven. One, two, three, and five, six, seven. One, two, she turns right, five, six, he turns right. One, two, she turns right, five, six, one more time, and one, two, three, and 5, 6, 7, and 1, 2, 3, and 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, he turns 5, 6, 7, she turns 1, 2, 3, and you finish 5, 6, 7. We are now going to focus and make a few pointers on the styling on this move. Notice that the contrabody motion is always working. Right off the basic into the cross-by lead, notice the arm styling on Duplessis. The hands are always fluidly moving. The handwork is very important that you stylize the hands. Always keep the hands and be aware of what the hands are doing throughout this movement. Notice the eye contact, that's also very stylish. Notice Angel's posture, his attitude. And also, what you do with your facial expression also adds to your styling. Notice that they really seem to be enjoying themselves. Notice how beautiful the skirt flows when the hips are swaying from side to side. Contrabody motion also by the men is very important. Very nice, Angel and Duplessis. One more time. Notice the recovery, very aggressive. And notice on Angel how his hands are also in stylized positions, even off the cross by the knee. Style pertains to what you're doing with your entire body from head to toe.